Here I am back in the office after spending the most incredible year of my life in Greece. As a middle-aged writer, I finally had the chance to realize a lifelong dream, to explore Greece for a few months and perhaps figure out why this little land continues to exert such a huge influence on me and on the imagination of almost everyone I know. Now I have a stone in my pocket and a story to tell. Where to begin? Well, as a boy, first I loved dinosaurs and then cowboys, but then abandoned them both for the more enduring passion of Greek mythology. The gods and goddesses, heroes and stories of ancient Greece awoke my slumbering imagination and lured me onto a path of discovery and my own brand of storytelling. I had traveled all over the world for work and play, and I thought that this trip to Greece would be no different. A month of exploring and research, looking for stories and pictures, but I ended up spending almost a year. Although I had read everything I could before coming to Greece, I wasn't prepared for the light. How clear and gentle and soothing it was. The light of Greece opened my eyes, penetrated my pores, expanded my whole being. Why is the light so different in Greece? I don't know, but it is. Everywhere else, the light just is, like your skin, vital but unnoticed. In Greece, it takes on a new dimension. It's luminous, soft, dazzling, legendary, tangible, infinite, spiritual. That's when it struck me, like an arrow, and I understood what the ancient Greeks felt about Apollo, the god of light. This sensation first hit me with all of its force on the island of Delos, where visitors still whisper in awe as they stroll through Apollo's lion-guarded sanctuary. This unique civilization profoundly shaped who we are and how we live, even today. It celebrated the triumph of reason over the violent and irrational, of democracy over the darkness of tyranny. It taught us to govern ourselves with moderation, to heal ourselves with the use of logic, and to express ourselves and our inner soul through art. It taught us about the rights and responsibilities of the individual, about the value of struggle, and the dignity of being fully human and free. Wherever you go all over the world, in every city and town, every university, museum, library, or bookshelf owes something important to Athena, goddess of knowledge and wisdom. It was a Greek idea that knowledge makes us free. And so I set out to explore more of Greece, starting with the kingdom of Poseidon. I had 1,000 Aegean islands to explore. Out of the sea, the islands emerged, archipelago of dreams, stepping stones of summer. Rose-colored beaches of breathless beauty, bathed in golden light, the delicate and delightful threshold of land and sea, where Aphrodite, goddess of love, lust, and loving-kindness, emerges from the waves. Secret and marvelous places and islands off the beaten track, unmentioned in guidebooks, unexpected and amazing. Sugar cube villages tumble down mountain slopes and spill into the sea. And when the day is done, The moon and her stars paint the sky in brilliant constellations, named from Greek mythology by ancient sailors navigating their way from island to island across the broad sea. As I traveled through the Greek countryside with its incredible variety, I began to appreciate the kindness and harmony of the land, which, like the Greek light, is never harsh or threatening. Rich fields of wheat express gratitude to Demeter. The olive trees which dot the Greek landscape are the gifts of Athena. It's hard to taste an authentic Greek meal without thanking these goddesses for their gifts and eternal generosity. Locked inside the autumn harvest of grapes lives the spirit of the most restless god of all, Dionysus, god of wine and spontaneous joy. Here, Dionysus is at home, and all are welcome. Summer ends, and life in Greece ripens toward the fullness and transformation of autumn. Birds and animals are on the move, and nature wears new colors as we walk through the forest with Artemis by our side. The call of adventure drew me upward into the thin air and snow. The mountains, how dramatic and beautiful they were in this special light. I thought that I would be disappointed in my quest for my childhood gods and heroes, but everywhere I turned, there they were. Ageless peaks capped with snow still echo with Zeus's thunder. Once upon a time, the father of the gods let loose two eagles who swept over the whole earth and met again here at Delphi, the center of the ancient world. Here, for thousands of years, visitors have journeyed from all over the world to this sacred spot to consult the famous oracle and to experience the tangible divinity of light. In Olympia, Hercules founded the Olympic Games, and even today, the Olympic spirit, an eternal flame, continues to burn bright. The games and contests of the Olympics celebrated not only the dignity of struggle and the glory of human excellence, but the timelessness of art and beauty as well. All those things men do to celebrate nature and add to its abundance. Traveling through Greece, everywhere you discover ancient theaters that still gather the energy of the earth and sky. At Epidaurus, I felt a stillness so intense that for a fraction of a second I heard the great heart of the world beat. And when a new god came onto the scene, he was also welcomed and accommodated. The old gods took on new names. Byzantine churches and monasteries were built, expressing the Greek people's gratitude for the miracle of life. Every place so unique, so different, so special. And the land's most precious inheritance, beauty, measure, proportion, and human scale, show a balance between man and nature and make visible the dimensions of the heart. I was a little wiser now about how to travel and see things with fresh eyes and how to understand things with the senses and not just the mind. Greece had made me free and whole. The world must become small again, as the old Greek world was. Small enough to include everybody. Greece has given me this incredible gift that I could now take with me anywhere. The ability to seize the moment and enjoy the fullness of life.